Dickey, Caddy was just talking about Charlie Hebdo. Clearly, there was a deliberate attempt at outrage with their cartoons and other things within the magazine. A line that many American newspapers would not cross, and yet the incendiary effect of it among the Muslim community in Paris. I am led to believe by several people I have spoken to that one of the issues here is that within the Muslim community, not only in France, but throughout the Middle East and perhaps here in the United States of America, they have yet to come to grips with the fact that nearly every Friday night in one pulpit or another, in one mosque or another, there is an incitement to violence that occurs too often. What do you hear about that strain of thought?
Well, I think there is a lot of that that goes on, but I think it can also be exaggerated. I think when it comes to freedom of expression and Charlie Hebdo and their level of provocation, I think there's a couple of contextual things that are good to keep in mind, and particularly here in France. One is there's a lot of talk about Charlie Hebdo's freedom to insult Muhammad. It's an equal opportunity attacker of religious and political figures. But you know, here in France, there are certain things that you cannot say because they are against the law. You can't deny the Holocaust here. You can't deny the Armenian Holocaust here. It's against the law to do it. Now, the Muslims will say, not all Muslims, but some of them will say, so why isn't there a law against defaming Muhammad? Why are there laws against some kind of speech and not laws against other kinds of speech? And it comes down to a political issue, and I think that's understood here in France, particularly by the Muslim community. In terms of incitement to violence, I think that's generally exaggerated. But of course, there are a lot of, you know, what would you call fundamentalist preachers in the Muslim world, just as there are crazy fundamentalist preachers in many other religions, Hinduism, Christianity, Judaism. Who will try and incite their congregations. I think it's an exaggeration here in France, and indeed certainly in the United States, to believe that they are finding a lot of followers who are embracing violence. The number of people who actually embrace violence, not just talk trash, but try to actually carry out terrorist events, is infinitesimally small. And I think we have to differentiate between anger and violence, because there is a gap there, and actually that's part of what keeps us as safe as we are.
All right, Chris.